Hey, my name is Venice, and welcome to my first Photoshop tutorial. Yeah, a few people asked me, how do you make your banner? How do you make your logo? How did you make your thumbnails? And in this video, I'm gonna show you how I did it. And before I really start, I have to say it's gonna take a little time. I didn't learn it like instantly. It's gonna take some time, alright? I practice like fucking every fucking day. I watched a lot of tutorials, and that's basically what you gotta do too. But this is my tutorial. It's one of the best ones, as you already know. It's really not. It's probably one of the worst, because when I talk too much, and I repeat myself like 20 times. So great! I'm using Photoshop as the program where I make my banners and logos and thumbnails. And maybe you use a different program, but I think Photoshop is a pretty good one. You know, there are some some other ways to get Photoshop, like those cheap motherfuckers. They just do the other way of getting Photoshop. I totally did it legit. I bought Photoshop for $500 per month for this program just to make some photos. I'm not lying, alright? I seriously bought it.
Shut the fuck up.
Alright, so let's get started! The first thing what you want to do is go to File, click on File. You see that file over the file, the little thing over here? Click on it. You click on New because, of course, you want to start a new project. If you click on that, you will see this tab with New. The name of the tab is New. And you see all these settings like width 1280 by and height is 720. These are all like settings, the size of your project. If you want to make a banner, it's 2560 by 1440. If you want to make a logo, it's 500 by 500. And if you want to make a thumbnail, it's 1280 by 720. And these are basically the settings where I make my thumbnails thingy. So I'm just going to start off with making a thumbnail. All right, these are the settings. You can copy it if you want. You just pause the video and you can copy the settings if you're doing along with me. I don't know. If you have all the settings for a thumbnail, just click on OK. And you will see this. And you will see this this weird looking rectangle with all these little squares, gray and white. It basically means that the picture is transparent. So there's the picture is just completely empty. Before we really start with making the thumbnail or just customizing it, we have to know some shortcuts for your keyboard, alright? Hopefully you are using a keyboard with your computer, or else I don't know how the fuck you're using your fucking computer. But basically, I'm gonna explain what some very useful shortcuts of your keyboards are. So, very important, click on if you did something wrong, alright? And you think, oh no, this is a mistake. How can I go back? Please tell me. I will show you. Just click on Control, Alt, and Z. Z? I don't know how you call it, alright? Control, Alt, Z. If you click on those three keys at the same time or something like that, it will go a step back. So your mistake can be erased. So let me just give you an example. I've got this little brush tool over here. If I just, do this. Oh no, I don't like the color pink, purple. Hey, let me erase it. Just click on Control, Alt, Z. And you see, it will be gone. It's like magic. I know. It's crazy, right? It's crazy. All right, next shortcut will be how to change the color of your picture, all right? To change the color of your picture or just something. If we do this, all right? Yeah. Oh, very, very nice purple, but I don't really like the color purple. So let me change it. Just click on Control U. If you do that, you will see this tab, Hue and Saturation. You can change the color, the saturation, the brightness of the thingy. So if we like this color, I really like this color, and we can change the saturation of it, like with like literally no color or with a lot of color. You could also make it really bright or really black. So that's how you change your color. I'm just gonna go pretty fast, but I'm still gonna try to speak carefully so you will understand and. Something like that. And now you think, you know what? I've got the thumbnail, the size and everything like that. Now I want to get a nice picture for my thumbnail. Well, if you want to do that, you first have to download it via like Google, like a Google thingy. Like you can get a picture and just save the picture on your computer. Then go to File, Then go to open. You see this little tab that says open? Click on it. If you click on it, you will see this tab. And you can just choose a picture. You want this avatar picture? Just click on Aang. Is that his name? That's his name. I'm pretty fucking sure. Shut up. Now there are two tabs, alright? Two tabs. But you want this picture. You want this picture to go over here. Your thumbnail size rectangle, alright? If you want to do that, just go to your picture that you want to move or something like that to your thumbnail thingy. Just go to that picture. So I will go to this avatar picture, all right? Then click on Control A. So you see this? You see that little outline around the picture? It's like a square outline, and it's black and white. You can see it a little bit moving if I zoom in on it. You can probably see it, you blind motherfucker. All right, just click on Control A. If you've done that, you will see that little line, black and white. It means that it selected the picture, all right? Then click on Control C. If we click on Control C, it will cut the picture. And when it cuts, you just have to go back over here. And you see this layer one? That's where you want to get your picture. Layer one. Photoshop works with layers. And this will be our first layer. So our first layer is going to be this picture. If you want to paste this picture in the thumbnail, just click on Control V. Right, and there is. There's a little cue for avatar, you know? It's really nice. Really, really nice. So what did we learn? Just go over here, Control A, Control C. And then go over here and click on Control V. You got me? You got it? Very smart. You're a very smart boy or girl, whatever you are. Transgender. I don't care. Now, if you've got this picture, all right? Now you think, oh, that picture's a little bit too small for my thumbnail, all right? And you want to change like the bigness, You want to change the size of the picture, all right? Just click on Control T. Control T, you got that? You just have to learn those shortcuts in your head. You can do it. If you just go through it a few times, you will get it, all right? You will get it. Just practice a lot. And when you practice a lot, practice something like that. Practice something else, all right? I don't really know what I'm saying, but I'm just teaching you how to use Photoshop. And shut the fuck up. I am a great teacher, all right? I am a great teacher. So if you click on Control T, you, of course, have to select the layer that you... So, you have layer 1, alright? And on layer 1 is your avatar picture. Now, just click on Control-T. If you click on Control-T, you will see this. You see this little square or rectangle around the picture? That means you can resize the picture. Now, if you think, oh, well, I can resize it now. If you do this, you see, it stretches out and you can do everything you want. You can even make a dance. Woo! Look at him go. So nice. But you see, now it just doesn't look good. So you want to go back, just click on this tab to deselect the resize feature. So click on here and apply. And when you've applied, you think, oh, that's a little bit too stretched out. I don't want that. Now you want to go back. What did we learn? Control Alt and Z. Ah, so nice. Now you want to make it bigger, but in the right quality of the picture, all right? So click on Control T again. You will get this square line around the picture. Just click on Shift, hold Shift, and then resize the picture. You see, now you can move it around, but it won't like be stretched out, and it will be the perfect size with great quality. Now you can resize it whatever size you want. We, of course, would like it big, because who doesn't like big things, right? So we'll make it like this big. I like it. I like this big. Now, if you think this is good, just go to the tab again to deselect the feature, the resize feature. So click on this little arrow over here or whatever. You can even choose something else, all right? Then go to apply. If you apply it, you know, it's that big. Really nice, right? It's not that simple. It's not that simple. It's not that complicated. It's very, very simple. Now, these are just the basics, all right? These are just some basic thingies that you, if you want to learn how to Photoshop, at least you have to know these things, all right? Now, if you just hold on the color that's underneath the other color, you will see set background color. If you want to if you want this color to be your background color, you can totally do that. Don't click on it, because then you can change the color. Let's say we like green. We want a green background. Totally fine with me, all right? If you want the background of your thumbnail green, you see it's now transparent because all of the little white squares. If you want it green, just click on Control Delete. If you click on Control Delete, it will turn green. I don't know why it's Control Delete. It's totally doesn't make any sense, but it's Control Delete. I'm teaching it. You shut the fuck up. So a new feature, Control Delete, will you can change the color, but the color has to be the color. There are two colors you can see, and the color that's underneath is your background color. If you change that color under here, over here, not the color that's above, but the color that's underneath the other color, if you click on it and we want a different color, like yellow, we'll take yellow. And you say, yeah, I don't like green. Who likes green? Are you fucking crazy? Let's go for yellow. I like bananas. So let's click on Control and Delete again. It will turn yellow. Magic, all right? I'm a magician. I don't know how I do it, but it's possible. Now, all right, I have this really sexy looking Asian chick, all right? I mean, it's a guy. It's a guy. Asian guy, all right? I have this really cool Asian guy. What I basically did to cut it out, there are two ways. There's a simple way and a really, not really difficult. It's gonna take more time. I'm gonna show you how to cut those pictures. So the easy way is like this. You click on this tool. I don't know what it's called though, but it's like this brush tool. It's the quick selection tool. And you just click on it. And when you click on it, you can select part of your picture that you want to cut out. All right. So let's say we only want the face. So you just click on the face. And you'll see these lines, alright? These black and white lines. That means you the parts that you selected. Now, if we select like a big part, alright? Like, let's select his forehead. We only want his forehead. Now, you've selected the part that you wanted to cut out and just click, right-click on it. If you right-click on it, it will say layer via cut. If you click on that, it will cut the picture. If you cut the picture, you can just, you know, If you see this little eye, and if you click on it, it will not show that layer, alright? So if you click on it, you see we only have the forehead now, but it's not very good quality. You can see all these bumps over here. It's not very precise. Now, if you want to do it more precisely, let's go back. How do we go back? Tell me. Right, that's right, that's right. Control Alt Z. Very good of you. You're a good student, aren't you? Very nice. So we are back with the nice Asian boy. Now, if you want to do it precisely, let's go to the pen tool. The pen tool is right above the text tool. If we click on that, you can just select a part, you know? If you only want, like, the forehead, you can do, like, click over here, and click over, like, here, and here, and here, and over here, and over here, alright? And just go back to connect all the parts. If you connected all the parts, you will see, like, this this frame around, like, the forehead. That's the part what I selected. If you right-click on that and just go to Make Selection, you can see that. Can you see that? Make Selection. Go over there, click on OK. And now what we learned, click on Control C, so it will cut the part of the picture. Control C, and then go to another layer, a different layer. Just click on the new layer here, over here. It will create a new layer. I just click on Control V. Now, if we go to the eye, if we click on the eye, the background will be gone. But you can see the part that we cut out will be there, the part of his forehead. So that's basically how you do with a pen tool. It's like a there are all different ways and shit, but that's kind of difficult. But if you do the difficult way, it will be more precise and it will look more good quality. So that's how I basically cut out my pictures. So basically, let's just shut up, alright? This is your thumbnail. It's a very nice looking thumbnail. Very professional, alright? Very, very professional. Now, if you would like to get some text on it, right? Like, every thumbnail has a little text on it. It doesn't have to, but you can do it. I'm just gonna show you how to do it. Just click on this little text tool over here. Of course, make a new layer. Make a new layer. For every single thing that you do, make a new layer. New layer. Alright, layer 3. And layer 3, you're gonna put our text. So let's click on somewhere where you want the text, all right, and let's write dildos, all right, very nice. Well, who doesn't like dildos? Now, to change the color of this thing, you have just select it, and you will see this little color rectangle over here. If you click on that, you can choose every color in the fucking rainbow, whatever you like. You want purple? get purple, and it will turn in purple, pinkish, however you want to call it, you colorblind motherfucker. All right, and now it's purple. Very nice. You want to change the size of it? Make it bigger? What did we learn? Just click on Control T. If we click on Control T, you can hold shift so it will get the right quality. Hold shift and make it bigger. You see, we like big dildos, so we like it big, very big. Ah, beautiful, 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 beautiful. Let's make it a little smaller or else it will not fit in my asshole. But if you start Photoshop and you just downloaded it, you will not get this font. If you don't know what a font is, it's like the typing style. All right, this is like a very elegant kind of style. I can also change it if I just select it and go over here. See this little here? Click on this tab and you will see all these little fonts, all these typing text styles, kind of. All right, and now I already have some downloaded. And if you want to download something, I'm gonna show you. Let me first show you this. All right, now most of the time I use this font. It's called Grow Bold. Now you won't have this font if you start a Photoshop. If you just downloaded it. How to get this font or how to get any font? Just go to Google or whatever you like, Firefox. Something like that. I don't care. All right, I don't care. Just go to Da Font. If you go in there and click on the site, and you will see all these fonts. All these fonts. You like this font? You like heading? Just download it. Click on download. It's pretty easy. Click on download, and then you will see this file. Click on the file. Just open the file, and then you will see all these thingies. Now you most of the time want to click on like this little icon with a letter, with a, like a little letter. It's a paper with like a little letter inside of it. If you double click on that, you will see this. It will show you this tab, all right? And then you it's in a different language in my thingy, on my computer, but it will basically say download. If you click on that, if you click on download, it will download it. You just have to wait. And then you just click on over here, just close everything. Then you want to go back to Photoshop, all right? Back to Photoshop. The font was called Heading. So if you select it again and go to your font tab, all right, where you can choose all the fonts, and you can see over here, Heading, small case, pro trial thingy, all right? Click on that, and you'll see it's now that font. It's very easy. It's not that difficult. So that's how you change the font and the color and everything like that. So this is really important if you're gonna make a banner. Also, a really important thing, if you go over here, the brightness and contrast and shit, you see all these little squares? If you click on it, it will automatically just create a new layer, and in that layer you can adjust the brightness of your whole thing, of your whole project, alright? So now we've got this, alright? We've got the template, we've got the letter dildos, let's see the dildos, and you can see the yellow shit, and the little fade, alright? The little goldish fade, alright? Now, if you want to change the brightness of it, just click on this one, this little square, the square, the first one. If you click on it, it will, you see this little, the little layer over there? It automatically just created that layer, alright? And now you can change the brightness. If we want it really high, you see, that's a really high brightness. You want the contrast really high, it's a really, like, high contrast. You know what I mean? And these are all, like, little presets you can mess around with to make your thumbnail look a little better. Like I said, this video is all over the place. I'm saying random shit, too fast, too slow. I don't really know, alright? But anyway, this was it for the video. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you learned something from my amazing Photoshop skills. If you did, make sure to spank the like button in the booty. In the booty? On the booty. You can also do it in the booty if you want to, of course. Spank the like button on the booty. Like a... What the fuck? What a... Oh my god. I wanted to do the Jacksepticeye intro. Like, I wanted to say, spank that booty. Like a boss. Let's not say that, alright? Spank the like button on the booty. You know what I like. And as always, stay goofy. Bye bye.